Hello, everyone, and welcome to this Nadex webinar, an introduction to Nadex short-term trading products. My name is Todd Rich. I am the head of education here at Nadex, and I will be taking you through the session today. I want to thank everyone for taking the time to join us. The first thing I'm going to mention is this session is being recorded. We are recording this. You will be able to get access to the recording, hopefully later today. You'll find it on the Nadex YouTube channel as well as on the Nadex website. I will show you where you'll be able to find that in case you want to go back and review it. I also know there's going to be a lot of folks who signed up for the session who couldn't join live, and so they're going to be consuming this on demand in their leisure. So that is why we record these and make them available. So let's get into it. Before I jump into the presentation, I do need to share this disclaimer that trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for everyone, that any trading decisions you make are solely your responsibility and at your own risk. And this is an educational session. Please do not construe anything I say as a buy or sell recommendation. We're doing this for your education purposes. That'll become abundantly more clear when I do what I like to call the off-roading portion of this, where I will step away from a slide deck, we'll jump into the Nadex platform, and I'll do some practical demonstrations. Anything I'm doing in there, I'm just doing it to demonstrate. It's not to give you an actual trade idea. Now, just a little bit about me, if you were curious, because you haven't joined one of my sessions before. I did join Nadex back in 2019. I've been in the financial services industry for decades. I can't believe it's been decades. I did start my career with Anderson Consulting out in California, coming out of business school. I did go to school out there for both my undergraduate and graduate degree. But when I came out to Chicago, and I was a trader on the trading floors for a while before moving into the exchange space, where I went to work for the exchanges and some very large brokerages like the New York Stock Exchange and E-Trade. Now I'm over at Nadex, and I've been here for a couple of years. Now, what are we going to talk about today? And today it's an introduction to all of our short-term trading products. So I'm not going to be doing a deep dive into each one of these, but I want to give you a high-level taste of what Nadex has to offer. Now, I will start off with who is Nadex to begin with, and just briefly, because I like to at least address why most people come to Nadex and how Nadex was designed specifically for retail traders. And when I say retail traders, a place for people to access the markets, and you don't have to have a lot of money in order to access price action in the markets. Then I will go through our different products. Binary options, probably the primary reason people come to Nadex, so I'll spend a little bit more time with them. But then I'm going to introduce you to knockouts and call spreads. I think once I explain knockouts, they might actually be our most intuitive product of all. But once you understand knockouts, understanding call spreads is pretty straightforward. I will go through examples of each, and then I'm going to do a very practical demonstration on the platform. As I like to say, my mom was born in the great state of Missouri, however you want to pronounce it, but it is the show me state, and I like to show you. I am actually going to show you the Nadex platform and then how you can see how each of the products are a little different when you're on the platform, but how you can take a look at them, whether they're binary options, knockouts, or call spreads, so you can access price action in the markets. And so let's start off with who is Nadex? Now, I don't want to spend a lot of time with this, but I think it's important, particularly for all the new folks who are coming to Nadex and looking for opportunities at the exchange. Nadex is an acronym. It's an acronym for North American Derivatives Exchange. We are a proper regulated exchange in the United States. We are regulated by the CFTC, another great acronym. We love those acronyms in the financial services industry. That is the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. We are a regulated exchange. And the reason I like to emphasize that is if you're looking to trade binary options, there are actually only three regulated exchanges. One of them doesn't really trade much volume at all. The other one has a different type of contract. Nadex is by and far the largest and most liquid and most highly traded binary options exchange, regulated exchange in the United States. Now, what's important to emphasize there is if you went on the internet and you were to look up binary options, you may be able to access offshore exchanges. There are binary options exchanges on the internet that are out in the world. They are not regulated in the United States. And the reason I mention that is there are some nefarious participants in the binary options space and that people go to, and they have problems. If you look up binary options, you're going to hear about all sorts of nefarious behavior, people who can't get their money out of their account or all sorts of other weird things. I can tell you at Nadex, none of that is true. We are a proper regulated exchange. We have a government body with oversight. We have to adhere to all the rules, laws, and principles of the United States. We are audited. None of that nefarious behavior goes on at Nadex because we are regulated. And so what I like to say is if you were to go to one of those unregulated offshore exchanges, and you may choose to do that if you wanted, but I would just say caveat emptor, buyer beware. If you were looking for any recourse, should anything go wrong, there will be no one that you could go to for recourse. They're just an offshore entity practicing business on the internet. Nadex is a proper regulated exchange in the United States. Now, why was Nadex invented? And it was really, we designed contracts specifically for retail traders. Now, what does retail traders mean? It's got a very low cost to entry. You do not need thousands of dollars. You can have very small quantities of money and access price action in the markets. And what's the other interesting thing about Nadex products is, you know, a lot of new people who are just coming in and trying trading for the first time, if you were to trade on a larger exchange, your risk is undefined. You could have unlimited risk depending upon what you did. At Nadex, it doesn't matter what you do before you do a trade. Every single one of our contracts before you enter a trade has very, very clearly defined risk. So you know what you're getting into right up front. So there are no surprises. And I'm going to discuss that as well. And people come to Nadex because they've got smaller sums of money. They're a retail trader. They want to try their hand at trading short-term price action. And we've got binary options, knockouts, and call spreads where people can do that. Now, that's the quick introduction. I would like to say on the right-hand side of your screen, you see a little question mark. If you've got any questions as we go, please type your questions in. I will do my best to answer them as I go. If I don't get to them at the end of the presentation, I will take a look and try to circle back and answer them. There's a high likelihood that if you've got a question, somebody else also has a question. And I want to make sure everyone who's here can benefit and get full advantage while you've got me in front of you. So we can definitely make this a bit of an interactive session if you've got any questions. Oh, you know what? I forgot. This is one last thing I want to do before I jump into it. If you're new to Nadex, or even if you're not new to Nadex and you've been around, we do have a refer a friend program. One thing a lot of retail traders like to do is trade with their friends. If you have a live account at Nadex, you will have access to your very own unique link to share with your friends. If your friends sign up using your link, and you would get that when you're in the platform, logged into your live environment. If they sign up using your link and they place 5 trades within 30 days of applying for their Nadex account, we'll give them $100 and we'll give you $100. They get $100, you get $100, everyone gets $100. You can actually do that with up to 10 of your friends, in which case you'll have $1,000 in your account. And if your account's in good standing, you could actually just take it out, or you can trade with it. And your friends, you know, this is a way for retail customers to get together and help each other and try different things. And I know that a lot of retail traders like to do that. They want to have that sense of community. There's an opportunity for you to do that at Nadex through our Refer a Friend program. All right, so let's first talk about binary options, and we're going to define binary options. Now, first up, they are a short-term defined risk reward contract that is based on an event or a statement or a prediction. So you've got this short-term defined risk reward contract based on something, an event, a statement, a prediction. Now, and we'll talk about that in a second. But in the end, there can only be one of two outcomes. Now, either the event occurs or it doesn't, or the prediction comes true or it's not. There are only two outcomes in the end, and I'm emphasizing in the end for a reason, and we'll get to that as well. But that's why they're called binary options, because in the end, it can only go one of two ways. The event happens, the event doesn't happen. The prediction is true, the prediction is not true. And what's interesting at Nadex is, and this is different than a lot of the offshore binary options exchanges, you can both buy or sell binary options. And we'll talk about that as well. You can take either side. And it doesn't matter whether you're buying or selling, your potential risk and reward are both known up front. They're very clearly defined, so there are never any surprises. Now let's talk about that event or statement or prediction. And that event or statement or prediction is made up of three components, right? And those three components, one, there's a market, two, there's a condition, and three, there's a time. Okay, now let's think about that. An underlying market could be anything. It could be an event like an economic event. Today we had initial jobless claims for this week. Tomorrow we're going to have non-farm payroll, and that there's an event. That's the market. It could also be, right? It could also be the S&P 500 or the NASDAQ or the Russell 2000 or the Dow Jones, or it could be oil or it could be gold. It's any market. Now we've got a bunch of different markets. It could be in a foreign exchange market, a foreign exchange pair, the Euro US dollar. We've got a variety of markets for you to choose from. Then there's always going to be a condition. That condition is sometimes referred to as the strike price or the level. And then there's going to be a time frame. There is going to be an expiration for each one of these. Now, the condition is generally, will it be greater than? So, for example, I'm just going to pick gold as a simple example. Will gold be greater than, will the price of gold be higher than 1800 at the end of today? Will the price of gold be higher than 1800 at the end of the week? Will the price of gold be higher than 1800 in the next 2 hours? So you've got a market, you've got a condition, and then you've got an expiration time. And the binary option that you trade is going to have a price range between 0 and 100. Okay. Now let's take it to the next level. Let's go. It trades between 0 and 100. What does that mean? Now, I've already mentioned that it's a true or false prediction. Either the event happens, the prediction is true, or it does not. Now, in the end, if the prediction is true, will gold be higher than $1,800 in the next 2 hours? If it becomes true and it's higher than 1,800, the option will go to 100. If it's false, it will go to zero. Now, when I said you can buy or sell, if you thought it were going to be true, you would buy the binary option looking for it to go to 100. If you thought the prediction were going to be false, it's not going to occur, you could sell it looking for it to go to zero. Now, what does that number between zero and 100 represent? And this is a really important point. This is to understand binary options. You can think of that price as roughly reflecting the probability of the event occurring, of the event being true, as determined by the market at that time. So when you look at a binary option, And will gold be greater than $1,800 in the next 2 hours? If it's trading for around 40, the market is telling you there's a 40% chance at that moment in time that the statement will be true, that it'll be higher than 1800 in the next 2 hours, at the end of the next 2 hours, and it would go to 100. Now it's telling you there's a 40% chance it would be true, right? Which means there's a 60% chance it's going to be false. That's 100 minus that 40. So there's a, when it's below 50, there's a higher probability that it's going to be false and a lower probability that it's going to be true. And if it were above 50, it would be the exact opposite. Now, if it were right at 50, all right, if my prediction, will gold be greater than $1,800 an ounce in the next 2 hours, and gold were currently trading right at 1,800, there's an equal probability, an equal chance that it would be above 1,800 as it would be that it'll settle below 1,800. There's a 50-50 chance you would expect the binary option to be trading right around 50. Now, I'm just going to show you some examples from an order ticket, but we will get into this, and you don't need to be able to do this math, but you should understand it. So here's an example of a binary option. It doesn't matter what it is. I'm looking at the price of a binary option. I told you it's going to trade between 0 and 100. This binary option is currently trading between 46 and 49, actually 46.25 and 49.25. If I took the midpoint of that, if I took the exact midpoint, it's 47.75. If I were to buy this binary option, there's a 47.75% chance, as predicted by the market, that it will go to 100. All right. Now, that also means there's a 52.25% chance that it's going to go to zero. Right, and that's the simple math that we're doing. You don't need to be able to do that. We do it for you. I will show you that. I just want you to understand it. Now, as I mentioned, you could sell a binary option, right? Here's a binary option where the price is 50 and a half bid at 54. The midpoint is exactly 52 and a quarter. Now, if I'm selling, I would have to say 100 minus that midpoint. If I were to sell this, I want it to go to zero. It's already above 50. There's only a 47.75% chance that it will go to zero because it's already at 52.25. There's a 52.25 that it would go to 100 as predicted by the marketplace. All right, this is just the market pricing that probability. Now, again, you don't need to be able to do the math, but when you're looking at it, on the one on the right, I'm doing an example of selling. If I were to buy that one on the right instead of sell it, and I were going to buy it, you know, it's offered at 54, the midpoint is 52.25. The probability that it would, if I were buying it, that it would go to 100 would be 52.25. Okay, and I think that answered the question that I got. If anyone else has more questions, please hit that question mark and type them in. But we will show you this on the order ticket. You don't need to be able to do this. I just want you to understand how it works. You are trading the probability of the event being true. And if you think it's going to be true, you buy it, looking for it to go to 100. If you think it's going to be false, you sell it, looking for it to go to zero. Now, when you're talking about the risk and reward, let's actually get into this. I told you, and this is the dollar amounts, I told you that it trades between 0 and 100, and we know that that number represents the probability. The other thing that we did at Nadex, at least for right now, is our contracts in the end have a total value of $100. So it is also that number that you see is also the current dollar value of the contract. So if I were to buy a binary option for 47.75, there's a 47.75% chance that it will go to 100. But what will I have to put up? What am I actually paying? If I bought it at 47.75, I'm paying $47.75 for one contract, looking for it to go to $100. Now, again, We do all the math for you on the order ticket. When you trade a binary option, the cost of your trade, what does it actually cost you to put up the trade? What is the collateral that you have to put up? And it's your maximum risk. If I'm buying a binary option, what I have to put up is the price I'm paying. So if I buy one at 47, I got to put up $47. All right, that's my risk. If I buy it at 47, my risk is it goes to zero. I can buy it for 47. If you're selling a binary option, it's 100 minus the sell price. So if I sell one at 47, all right, 100 minus 47 is 53. I'm selling it at 47. Now, my risk is it goes to 100. I would have to put up $53 in order to sell one at 47. And what am I risking? I'm risking my $57. Now, what could I potentially make? It's the other side. If I sold one at 47, my goal is it goes to zero. That's the most I can make. I could sell it at 47. It goes to zero. I make 47, but I had to risk 53. When I'm buying, if I bought one at 47, yes, I'm risking 47, but what I'm hoping for is that it goes to 100. I could potentially make 53. I'm risking $47 to make $53. Again, we do all of this math for you. I wanted to walk you through it. So now if you look at an actual order ticket, here's an order ticket to buy. Remember, this is not trade recommendations, but on an order ticket, there'll be the current indicative price of the underlying asset. Will gold be higher than this price? Is non-farm payroll going to be greater than this number? We've got other event contracts that we've got in our demo environment where we're playing around with some things. I'll actually show you. Will the number of vaccinated Americans in the United States be greater than X number, you know, at the end of the month? I mean, there's all sorts of conditions that we could put, but there'll be an indicative price on the order ticket. There'll be the expiration time, and this is currently the US 500. This is the S&P 500, and it'll give you the condition. Will the S&P 500 be higher than 46.59.60 at 4:15 p.m., and it's telling me this expires in 22 hours, which means it's 4:15 p.m. the next day. And we currently see that it's trading right now at 46.59.33. It's already, it's actually right there. It's right there at 50. I mean, is it going to be higher than 46.59.60? We're actually slightly below it. We're 27 cents below it. But the market was predicting that, you know, it's slightly higher than 50% because people think the market's going to go higher. But you will have a market where you can buy or you can sell. Now, here's an example. Do you have to trade on the prices there? The answer is you can. I can see, and you can see in the upper right-hand corner of the 53 that there's a 200. I can see there's 200 contracts offered at 53 and a quarter. Can I put an order in between the markets? And the answer is yes. I can say I don't want to pay 53 and a quarter. I might only be willing to pay 52.75. Now, am I going to buy it at 52.75? I don't know. I can put my bid out there, and if somebody else wants to sell it to me, I will. But if they don't, I might, you know, the market might move away from me. But you can place bids and offers between the market. In fact, you can place bids below the market. You can place offers above the market. It is what we call a central limit order book. Anyone can post limit orders on the marketplace. That's what makes a market. Now, when you're looking at your order ticket, you can see the maximum profit and maximum loss are calculated for you. You don't have to do the math that I did earlier. If I were to buy one at 52.75, and I were to buy it, I know that I would have to put up 52.75. That's the most I can lose. And what the most I can make is it goes to 147.25. This is if I'm buying one in between. Now, we also do a return on investment. as well as a probability of it being in the money, the return on investment number, I'm risking 52 to potentially make 47. We actually take out the cost of the transaction, because there is a transaction cost that tells you that, yeah, you could potentially make 84% on your money in 22 hours if your prediction is correct. Now, if you look at the bid ask in between the middle of this market, 50 to 53 and a quarter, it's 51 and 5/8, 51.63. The market is saying if I were to buy this, there's a 51.63% chance that it will go to 100. Now, that also means there's a pretty high probability it can also go to zero, but this is what the market is pricing the probability as. Now, I just want to give you an example of a sell order just in comparison. Here's one where will the S&P 500 finish higher than 4572? All right. Now, in this case, it's already 4570. It's already well above 4572, and there's only an hour and a half to go. I mean, that's really important for you to look at the expiration time. I'm going to look at the right now. If I were to buy it, there's a higher probability. There's a 58% chance it's going to go to 100. That's the middle of this market. But I'm selling one. All right, I'm selling one, and if I were to sell one, it's 100 minus 58. Selling one, my probability of success of selling one in here. Right now, the market's saying there's only a 42% chance that it will go to zero. All right. Now, if I sold one at 59, which is in between the bid-ask spread, all right, I sell at 59, it could go to 100. So it's telling me I have to put up $41, because if I sell at 59, it could potentially go to 100. I have to put up $41. But what could it do? If I sold it at 59, it goes to zero. I could potentially make $59. And there, I'd be making almost 100, actually, I would be making 126%. If I sold one, if I put up $41 and I made 59 and I take out your transaction costs, my max return on investment would be 126%. And I'd be doing that in an hour and 39 minutes. All right, hopefully that's all clear, but it's really important for you to understand what these prices represent. It's the probabilities, and with a Nadex contract, with it being $100 per contract, the math is done for you, but you can see what you're risking and what you're potentially making. And if I wanted to risk more or potentially make, if I want to risk more to potentially make more, I could change my contract size. I don't just have to trade one. I could trade two. I could trade three. Some people will trade several and scale in and out of their, they'll scale into a trade and out of a trade. But I'm doing this all with one, so you can clearly see what it is for one. But we calculate your max ROI as well as the probability of your trade being in the money as determined by the marketplace at that moment in time on the order ticket for you. All right, now that's, I did spend more time with binary options. I'm now going to get into knockouts and call spreads. I think I've answered the questions, but I did want to spend more time with those because those binary options, and when we do some examples, you'll get to see them in action. Now, what are knockouts? A knockout is also a contract, but a knockout trades within a set range. And a knockout range has two prices. There is a floor and there is a ceiling. And the price of the contract, so again, let's use oil in this case. The price of the oil will trade between the floor and the ceiling, and it moves directly in line with the underlying. So unlike a binary option where I'm looking at the probability of it finishing at 100 or finishing at zero, with oil, you're just trading the price of oil. There it is. It's what we call a Delta One product. Now, the thing is you're trading the price. I'm trading the price of the NASDAQ index. I'm trading the price of the S&P 500. I'm trading the price of the exchange, the Euro US dollar exchange rate. It's the price. The price you're trading is the price that you see. And it's got this floor and ceiling around it, and we're going to talk about that in a second. But just like any other market, if you think the price is going up, you simply buy it because I'm thinking it's going to go higher. And if I'm thinking it's going to go down, I can sell it. I'm looking for it to go lower. Now, with a knockout, we've got these boundaries around it. A knockout can expire in one of two ways, price or time. And let's go through these examples, because once you understand this, call spreads will be a breeze. If the indicative index for the underlying market touches the floor or ceiling of a knockout, the trade ends. It expires. It is called a price-triggered settlement. So if I buy a knockout and I've got a floor and ceiling around it, if it goes down to the floor, I bought it and it went down to the floor, I am knocked out of the trade. Now, I bought it, it went down, I'm going to experience maximum potential loss. On the flip side, if I buy a knockout, I think oil's going higher, I buy a knockout, and it goes up and it touches the ceiling, I would be knocked out of the trade and I experience maximum potential profit. Now, if I buy it and it keeps going higher, it doesn't matter. I got knocked out of the trade, but I experienced maximum potential profit. If I buy it and it goes down and I get knocked out of the trade, it doesn't matter how much lower it goes. I'm out of the trade, I experience maximum potential loss, and I'm protected from any more losses. So it gives you a very clear defined risk, defined reward. And you get knocked out, that's why they're called knockouts, if it touches either the floor or the ceiling. Now, a knockout does have a time range to it. We set them up initially as week-long contracts. Now, if it doesn't touch the floor or the ceiling during the period of the contract, it will settle at the end of the week, it will expire, and we call that a time-triggered settlement. And what will happen is, if you bought a knockout and it never touched the floor or ceiling, your profit or loss on the trade would be the difference between where you bought it and where it settles. If you bought it and it settles higher, you would have a partial profit. You never got maximum profit because it didn't hit the ceiling. If you bought it and it trades down but doesn't touch the floor and it settles at the end of the week, you'll have a partial loss, but you would never have experienced maximum potential loss because it never touched the floor. And the same goes true. It's just the exact opposite. If you sell, you can sell. I think the price of the NASDAQ is going to go lower, so I sell the NASDAQ index. Now, if it goes up and touches the ceiling, I was wrong, but I'm knocked out, I experience maximum potential loss. If it goes down to the floor and touches it, I was right, it went down, I experience maximum potential profit, and I'm knocked out. If I sell it because I think the NASDAQ is going lower and it doesn't touch the floor or ceiling, I will have a partial profit or partial loss in the end, because it never touched either the floor or the ceiling. All right, and I think we're all, those are pretty intuitive. It's a Delta One product. It's like trading anything else. I think people are, and yes, there are people, I'm getting, you know, I wanna answer these as we go. We do have technical indicators, we have drawing tools, we have all sorts of things. In fact, I want to get over to the platform to show you how you can do some analysis to help you with your trading decisions, but we have all of that baked into the platform. And in fact, we even have the levels for knockouts and call spreads on the charts, so it's easy to see where the boundaries are right on the chart itself. So with knockouts, what it really comes down to is it's a built-in trading plan. It's a built-in trading plan for retail traders to have very clearly defined risk reward before you get into a trade. You know what your maximum risk is. You know what your maximum potential reward is before you place the trade. You've got that floor and you've got that ceiling, and those give you natural profit targets as well as defined risk control. So the very structure of a knockout, if you're buying it, you've got a profit target. That would be the ceiling. You've got a stop loss level. That would be the floor. So you can pick, and we've got different knockout ranges where you can choose how much are you willing to risk for what potential reward, and know that if it touches the floor or the ceiling, there is no slippage. There is no sending an order to get you out of the trade. It is the contract simply expires. It's done. We will then list a new knockout. Now, if you're selling, your profit target is the floor. I'm selling. I want it to go down to the floor, but I've got a ceiling. If I sell it and I'm wrong and the price goes up, I've got my stop loss in case I am wrong. And with knockouts, those are very hard levels. If it touches the floor or ceiling, you are knocked out of the trade. And a knockout is really a Delta One product. I buy it if I think it's going up. I sell it if I think it's going down. And it's got a trading plan baked into the product to force you to be disciplined, to stop losses if you're wrong, as well as take profits if you're right. Now, on an order ticket, here's a crude oil order ticket. I've got my indicative price. I've got the time to expiration. I've got the range. Now, if I thought oil were going lower, I could sell one. Now, if I were to sell one here, I'm saying I'd like to offer one at 70.61. If I sold it at 70.61, I know the ceiling is only 64 cents higher. It's 71.25. If I sold it at 70.61, I'm risking $64. I sell it looking for oil to go lower, but it goes up and hits that ceiling. Oops, I was wrong. I'm knocked out. I lost $64. If I'm right and oil were to go lower and it were to touch 66 and a quarter and it went down, I could potentially make $436. So there is very clear defined risk reward calculations, whether you're buying or whether you're selling a knockout. And we offer multiple knockouts so you can choose how much you're willing to risk for what type of potential reward based upon whether you're buying or selling. And I will get into that on the platform. Now, when it comes to call spreads, if you understand knockouts, call spreads are easy to understand. A call spread is also a contract that has a predefined range. It also has a floor and a ceiling. And a call spread, the price of a call spread will move in line with the price of the underlying, similar to knockouts. Not the same, but similar to knockouts. Now, what makes a call spread different? And a call spread is different from a knockout in two very, very important ways. Number one, it only expires at expiration. There is no price-triggered settlement in a call spread. So if I buy a call spread and it goes down through the floor, oops, I was wrong, you are not knocked out of the trade. You still own that call spread. Now, when you bought it, you bought a price, right? And you can't lose any more than what you paid. So your risk is still defined. But with a call spread, you have time to potentially be right. If I buy it and it goes through the floor and I'm not knocked out, but then it comes right back up, I'm still in my call spread. A knockout, you would have been knocked out. And this has happened to people before. Who hasn't this happened to? Where you buy something, it goes down, it hits your stop, you get out of your trade, only to then have it come right back up and you go, oh God, I can't believe they stopped me out of the trade and then I was right. Well, a call spread gives you that optionality. If I, now, that also is a double-edged sword. If I buy a call spread and it goes up through the ceiling, I'm still in the trade. I am not knocked out. And if you're not paying attention, it could turn around and come all the way back down and you had profits and then you missed your opportunity to take those profits because you're still in that call spread. You didn't get knocked out. All right. Now, because there's that optionality, all right, a knockout's a Delta One. The price is the price and it's going to move track right in line with the underlying. A call spread is going to have a premium in it. There's going to be a premium because you have that optionality. And that premium will increase or decrease based on how much volatility there is in the product, as well as how much time to expiration. So volatility and time to expiration will be factored into the price of a call spread. It will not be the exact price of the underlying. And I will show you that. But with that, so it's going to cut the optionality of not getting knocked out so that you can stay in a trade is going to come at a cost because there is a premium baked into it. And I will go through some examples. Now, alert, alert. If you take nothing else away from today, this is very, very important. And this is an important rule when trading any Nadex product, whether it's binary options, knockouts, or call spreads. Just because there's an expiration associated with the contract does not mean you have to wait until then to see what happens. That is really, really important. You are not married to the trade. You are not stuck with it. Once you trade a binary option, knockout, or call spread, you do not have to wait to see. Now, you can choose to wait and see what happens. And at expiration, we know how everything settles up, but you can choose to exit a position early. You can get out of a position early. Now, why would you want to get out of a position early? And there's two reasons why you would want to do that. One would be to lock in profits, and the other would be to minimize losses. So let's think about that. I buy a binary option for 40. I'm looking for it to go to 100. I've risked $40, all right? But I'm wrong and it goes down to 20. Now I know there's only a 20% chance for it to go to 100. And I gotta reassess. I bought it at 40, I risked 40. I was looking to make 60 because I wanted it to go to 100. Now it's at 20, I've lost $20. Do I have to lose all 40? And the answer is no. I could choose to simply sell my binary option back at 20 and get out and stop my losses and say, I bought it for 40, it went to 20, I sold it at 20, I only lost 20, I live to fight another day. I do not have to lose all 40. Now on the flip side, I buy it at 40 and it goes to 80. All right, I've doubled my money. I risked 40, I was looking to make 60 because I want it to go to 100, I would like to see that. Now it's at 80 and I can make a decision. Do I want to stay in this trade at 80 and try to get the last $20, which you may want to do? Hey, I want to make the full 60 bucks. Or you could say, hey, I bought it at 40, it went to 80, sold, thank you very much, I'm out of my trade, I made $40, and I'm gonna go look for another trade, and I don't have to worry about it potentially going lower and me losing the $40. I could lock in my profits of $40 and walk away and say thank you and again, move on to my next trade. With knockouts, it's the same way. I don't have to let it hit the floor or ceiling. Now, a lot of people, when they buy a knockout, they'll buy it when it's close to the floor. That's their stop loss. But if it goes up, do you have to wait for it to make full profit? No, it can move higher in that knockout range, and you could simply sell it back out and take a profit, and you're done, and move on to your next trade. You don't have to wait and see if it turns around. You've got to make those determinations. You can exit a trade early. Now, with call spreads, that's really important. Now, with a call spread, I buy a call spread because it's near a floor. It might even be below the floor. And I'm looking for it just to go higher. I'm paying a premium for that. And it goes up. It goes through the ceiling. Remember, I'm still in that trade. And it could turn around. For me to exit my call spread, I don't have to wait to expiration. In fact, a lot of call spreads, rarely do call spreads, do people hold call spreads to expiration. They'll simply trade out of them. If it goes up through that ceiling, people will sell it and take the profits, all right, and get out of the trade. You've made a lot on the trade, and that's great. Might as well get out. And conversely, if I sell a call spread, I'm looking for the price to go lower. It goes up. I'm wrong. It goes through the ceiling. I'm still in the trade. I still have time. And if it were to turn lower and go down, I could buy it back at a lower price. If it went through the floor, remember, on a knockout, you would be knocked out and you take your profits. On a call spread, I actually have to buy it back. You're not knocked out like a knockout. Knockout hard ranges. Call spread, you're going to probably look to unwind your position, particularly if it's a profitable one, because you don't need to wait because it will settle at expiration. But you know, you don't have to wait until then to see what happens. Now, I just want to give you an example. We do offer functionality like this for our binary options. For our call spreads and knockouts, you're going to need to place those orders, and I'll show you that. But on a binary option, we actually have functionality for you to close a position early. And, you know, I think it really helps. So in this particular example, you can see I bought, will the S&P 500 be greater than 45, 59, 60? I bought one at 53 and a quarter. All right. It tells me I bought one. I could set a profit goal. If I bought it at 53 and a quarter, I could say, all right, where would I want to sell it? And I could change, I'd sell it up at 82 and a quarter. If it went up to 82 and a quarter, I know that I'd make $29, and you could place a limit order to sell one up at 82 and a quarter. So if you step away from the computer and it jumped up there real quickly, you would exit the trade, make your $29, say thank you very much, and move on to the next trade. So you can set profit targets. We also have just close your position. I bought one at 53 and a quarter. I didn't mean to buy one. All right. I know the bid is currently 50 and a quarter. It tells me I could just simply close the order with a market order and take a $3 loss. If I bought one, I could say, just close my order, get me out. And we do have a close position button where you will simply liquidate your position with the market order. And at that moment in time, it would tell you if you would be making a profit or loss. In this case, it would be for a small loss. It could be for a profit. You could just close an order. Closing a position with the close functionality, it's a market order. With on binary options, and we only currently have this on binary options, you can set profit targets and place a limit order away from the market. Now, with that, if you got any other questions for us, I am going to get to the platform now. I really want to get into the platform piece. I want to do a practical demonstration. We'll probably spend 5 or 10 minutes doing that. But if you got any questions, please email us, customerservice@nadex.com. We're here to help. We can only help you if you've got questions around your account, our markets, anything. We are here to help. I'd also say follow us on social media, and I'm going to emphasize YouTube. In fact, I am going to show you why I emphasize YouTube, and specifically to the question we just got around, do we have indicators for people to help determine price? We do more than that. We actually try to help you by doing some early morning analysis each day to look at hot spots in the markets. So let me switch my screen. Give me 1 second here. Oh, no, you know what? I just have to do this. I don't have to switch my screen. I just have to do this. Okay. By the way, this is our Nadex YouTube page. And I would highly recommend you just go to YouTube, look up Nadex, and subscribe to our channel. We are constantly publishing content. Every day we publish content. We have some recorded content. You can go up and look, and we've got some playlists. But if you want to see what we're doing every single day, you click on the videos button, and you can see we've published videos. This session will be recorded. You'll see this right in here later today. You can take a look through at what else we've got. Every day we do 2 other videos. Our CEO, Travis McGee, does what I would say like a 1 to 2 minute quick hit early in the morning. It's a bit motivational, and it talks about, you know, just his thought process on what he's looking at. It is very quick. It is very down and dirty. It is maybe a minute, rarely 2 minutes. And it's great to hear from our CEO. Every morning with a partner, I do morning market movers. It is at 8:45 a.m. Eastern every day, 7:45 a.m. Central. We go for about 15 or 20 minutes, and every day we look at hot spots in the markets, and we do some live analysis for day trading. We look at the charts. We talk about the news. We talk about how that news could be impacting the markets. We talk about what type of news events or economic reports and releases might be coming out through the day, or who might be speaking throughout the day, so that you know when there might be volatile times in the markets, and you can look, hey, today there's an oil inventory report at 10:30 a.m. Here's where you might want to be looking when this number comes out, because oil might move. We highlight, and if you want to go back and look at these, you can see what we did for today. In fact, if I go here under videos, I can see all the past live streams. Now we did take a week off around Thanksgiving, but you can go back and see how did we, you know, and we've been doing this for quite a while. But they're only really relevant for the day that we did them. But you can take a look, and if you can't join, they're immediately available. So if you can't join, you can watch the recording. If you want to go back and watch today's recording, you certainly can. You can even set reminders. Now, I've only got one live stream programmed right now. That's for tomorrow morning. Later today, I'll be putting up the next week. I usually keep a week of these out here, and you can actually, if you're subscribed, you can set a reminder that says, "Hey, remind me." They're going live, and we stream it all live on YouTube. And you could type in questions to us that day if you would, you know, "Hey, what are you seeing here? What are you seeing here?" We'll take a look at it. Again, nothing's a trading recommendation. We're simply doing some analysis and talking about current market conditions and current market news. All right, so that's why I recommend our YouTube channel. It is very handy. It is very helpful. Now I am going to jump over to our platform, what I really wanted to get into. Now, here on the platform, if you're not familiar, we've got our binary options in the upper left-hand corner, the call spreads, and the knockouts. Let's play around with binary options first. We could do any. If anyone has a particular market, type into the questions, "Hey, would you take a look at the S&P or use oil for an example?" Feel free to type that in. I'll try to incorporate that in, but in the meantime, I'm just going to grab anything. By the way, I do want to point out, in demo, we're going to be coming up with a lot more of these. These are event contracts. Some of these, like non-farm payrolls and the unemployment rate, we do have these in production. We are testing out some other, and these are in demo only, crude oil inventory levels. We know that next week there's going to be a crude oil inventory report on Wednesday. And the question is the U.S. oil inventory supply going to increase or decrease? And these are number of barrels of oil. And you can make a prediction. "Hey, I think it's going to be, whatever it is," you can play around with these. We're going to be adding a lot more of these. We're testing these out right now. Here's one on even, this one's actually going to close in 32 minutes. This is interesting. Is the number of vaccinated Americans, is it going to be greater than this number? Yes or no? That number is about to expire. So they're kind of fun contracts, but let's take a peek at an equity index. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ. Let me refresh because we see some of these expired. I'm going to just take a look at the NASDAQ, and you can see we have all of these strike prices. You know what I'm actually going to do? I'm going to do something a little different. We do have, as you can see in indices, we've got hourly contracts, daily contracts. Sometimes they're every couple of hours. We got weekly contracts. We even have our very short duration. These are all in foreign exchange. I'm going to come back in a minute and a half when that resets. And here's a 20 minute. Here's the 20 minute on the S&P. You can see all the strike prices and you can see all the probabilities and you can make a determination. What do you want to do? If I think we're going to go higher in the next, and these expire in 6 minutes, I might look at one of these binary options. I might change this to a 15 minute chart. If I think it were going higher, I would buy it. Maybe I want to buy one at 44. Oh, look, it's getting away from me. I'm just going to put one in at 44. I'm placing one in between the bid-ask spread. Oh, I just bought it. All right. And we can see how quickly these are moving with 6 minutes to go. I do have a position. I bought one at 44. Now, what can I do? If I decided I'm wrong, I could just close my position or I can set a profit target. I bought it at 44. I'd sell it at 54. I'd take a quick 10 bucks. All right. I can just go up here and say, "All right, you know what? I would sell it up at 54. And I'll place my limit order up above." Now it's currently going against me. All right. I look at my positions. I can see I was wrong, but I'm willing to sit here with it. It might come back. And maybe I'm willing to risk that $44. We'll see what happens. We'll come back in a couple of minutes. I do want to go over to our 5 minute binaries. I want you to see, these are about to reset, so let's refresh. Because I want you to see, as you get close to expiration, binary options can become quite volatile. All right, here's the Euro USD. Let's go ahead and show these strikes. I want to see them on here. I'm going to drop this down to a 1 minute chart because this is a 5 minute contract. I'm going to expand this here. Now my trade is turning. It's bouncing around on the other one. But I want you to see what happens here. This is a 5 minute binary option. I want you to see how volatile these can be. When we first started, this was around a 50%. And since then, it's ticked lower, and this is quickly dropping. Look, watch the price on this drop even lower quickly as the price ticks down. Now we're getting a little bit of a bounce. I don't know. Oh, look at that. By the way, I got taken out of that other trade. I made $10. Great. Okay. As you can see, binary options, it's volatile. There's opportunity to trade, particularly as you get closer to expiration. The probabilities on these will move pretty dramatically as the price of the underlying moves around, right? We just saw this one that was in the 50s tick up now closer to 80, and we're still dancing around in here. I don't know, because in the end, each one of these is either going to go to 100 because it's true, or they're going to go to zero because they're false. Now, do I have to wait until then to see what happens? No, as I showed you on earlier on this S&P 500 trade, I bought one at 44. Now, it dropped down. I was down $20 and I just stayed in the trade, and then it eventually actually came back up and it went to 54. I made my $10 trade. I don't even know where that contract is right now because I'm more interested right here in the Euro USD. Look at this. I mean, these were in the 20s. It's now above. We're hovering right around this 113.03 level. And you can see how you could potentially trade these back and forth. We could have bought this one lower and taken it off for a profit right now. Why would I have done that? I don't know. In the last minute, this thing could drop below and who knows? I mean, you can see how some of these candles have moved through multiple levels very quickly. So short duration binary options, lots of volatility. And now some people don't like it to move around that quickly. They would rather have a little bit more time to analyze, in which case, you know, you might look at a longer duration contract. Here's a daily S&P 500. You know, you're going to see now we've moved higher in the S&P. We've actually blown through all those strikes. I'm wondering if that's true for all of these dailies. No, here's the NASDAQ. We've got a plenty of strikes. Here's the NASDAQ where we've got, there's still 3 hours to go here in the NASDAQ. You can see all the strikes we've got and all the probabilities that you have. I don't want to, let's put this on a 5 minute chart. It's going to make it a little easier. All right. And you can see all of the different probabilities. Now, someone had asked, what kind of tools do you have? I'm going to take away all of these strike prices. We do have analytical tools. All right, I am going to just do this for a second, put this back in the middle here. So for instance, we do have all of these technical indicators baked into the platform. If you like to use moving average, convergence, divergence, I can put it on here and you can actually see the MACD going. If I want to use something else, for instance, Bollinger Bands, I could put my Bollinger Bands on there. If I want to have specific parameters to my Bollinger Bands, you know, it defaults in as a 20 minute period with two standard deviations. I could change however you like to set them up. You can even change the colors. You could change how it displays. You can set it all up and you can save your charts and it will remember. What else do we have in here other than, and if you're not familiar with what all of these technical analysis tools are, we do have some in-platform basic education for you to learn a little bit about it, like relative strength index and what does it mean and how do people use it. Now, what else do we have? We have our drawing tools. People like to do their own analysis on their own charts. You can put in whatever you like. You want to put in your own support and resistance levels. You want to draw your own, put in your where you see supply and demand equilibriums. If you see trends or channels, you can put them in. Where's my channel? Here's my channel. If you're looking at, here's a upward channel. I'm going to force fit this here. You can put your own drawing tools on for you to do your own analysis. If you happen to like Fibonacci retracement levels, I'm going to click Fibonacci. Oh, you know what? Before I do that, let's actually just take a look at, I'm going to make the past week. Let's make this a 30-minute chart because I'm doing a week. And we know, there we go. All right, this was on Monday. If I wanted to see what was going on with Fibonacci this week, here's my Fibonacci retracement. I could start at the high from earlier in the week. I can go down to the low, which we saw today, and I've got my Fibonacci levels where I can be looking for retracement levels. It is rather interesting how that 50% level has been important a couple of times. But, you know, we blew right through it, and now we're playing around with the 23.6 level. We're dancing through here. So the question, do we have indicators and can you do have drawing tools? The answer is yes. Now, I spent a lot of time, again, on binary options. I do want to show knockouts quickly, I didn't spend as much time on these, and I do sessions geared specifically for them. With our knockouts, you can see on the chart, these four vertical lines, they give you your knockout levels. They give you your floor and ceiling. If I were looking for, this is the S&P 500 to go lower, I might want to use this one to sell, all right? I know where my floor is. Now, I know that I can't, if it goes up, I'm risking 75. I know where I'm selling it here, and I know that where my ceiling is if I were wrong. If it were to come all the way down here, I know where my max profit is. But if you're selling, you might want to choose one that's close to the ceiling. If you think it were going higher and you were buying, you might want to choose one that's closer to the floor, so you're limiting your risk, right? But you've got very clear boundaries, and your floor and your ceiling are drawn on the chart for you to help you choose which knockout you want. Now, call spreads, similar-ish with call spreads. Let's go over to our S&P 500 call spreads. I'm still on knockouts. Helps if I click on call spreads, go to indices. And for S&P 500, I got to choose which time frame I want. And then I can click through. I'm going to hide this now. And it's a shaded region for the call spread. All right. And as you click, you can see the floor and the ceiling. Now, again, a lot of times when people are buying call spreads, they might want to buy one. I mean, this is all the way through the ceiling already. If I thought it were going lower, look, I could sell this call spread. Now, it's all the way up here. It's well above the ceiling. I could still lose $45. That's the premium that's baked in here if this were to come lower, to potentially make $255 if it were to come all the way back down at the end of the day. So you can see how there is a premium level, and because we've been so volatile today, these premium levels can be significant. There's still 3 hours in this contract. But you can go back and you can look at the different call spreads and knock. Now the knockouts are weekly, and every time one gets knocked out, we add one. With call spreads, we've got different time frames, and so you'll have to look at each one of the different time frames to see. You know what the call spread looks like, and then when you click around on the different call spreads, it will give you the different ranges for each call spread. And again, the math for everything is done for you. All right, if I thought this were going lower, this might be the one I want to sell. I mean, these are much smaller contracts. Again, the width of the contract and the values, everything for your risk and reward is calculated for you on the order ticket, so you know what you're getting into before you enter a trade. All right, with that, I want to thank everyone for joining us. I want to remind you, follow us on YouTube. This recording will be up later. Take a look at our website. We're constantly offering additional education. Next week, we have a boot camp. It's going to be a day-long boot camp. I'll be going through something a little bit similar to this, but I've also got Brian Caprice, who's going to talk about trading strategies around knockouts and call spreads. We've got Tom Sosnoff from Tasty Trade, who's going to talk about why do people want to get into day trading or trading in general? So really going to be some great stuff. I've got Mark Pietrino from Benzinga, the head of education and their chief market technician, that's going to be doing a presentation around technical analysis. So I'd encourage you, if you want to learn more, next week we do have a boot camp, but we're always adding more webinars and doing more, particularly if you want to do a deep dive into our platform. My colleague Adam McCaden does those every couple of weeks. You'll find those in the webinar section. Yes, knockouts are set up, by the way, and this is the last question I'm going to answer. Knockouts are set up for weekly contracts because through the week, they're constantly getting knocked out and we're adding a new one. Call spreads, we have different time frames throughout the day. Some people want to see longer term call spreads, but when they also do longer term call spreads, the premium component gets much larger because there's a lot more time to expiration. But with knockouts, remember, you can trade all of these in a window of an hour or 20 minutes or 2 hours or a day. It's just the expiration. A knockout has an expiration at the end of the week, but realize that throughout the week, it's probably going to be touching some of those boundaries. And every time we knock one out, we add a new one so that there are generally always four knockout ranges for you to choose from to help you manage your risk. With that, I want to thank everyone for joining us. I want to remind you, come in the mornings on Nadex YouTube, we live stream. We live stream morning market movers, set reminders, subscribe to our channel. We do all this for free. Please share it with your friends. Let them know these resources are available. We give them away. We want to help you. We really want to help you be better traders and hopefully help you become successful trading. Thanks for joining today. This recording will be available later, and good luck in the markets, everyone.